Remember who you are. I believe this imperative. I'm a PK, a preacher's kid. For me, that meant living in a fishbowl where most of what I did was observed by others. It also meant that I frequently experienced many aspects of life's path, such as births, baptisms, marriages, and funerals. As a young child, I thought that I understood the meaning of my father's statement, "Remember who you are," as meaning that I had to live in such a way that was considered proper or appropriate according to some supposed moral compass prescribed by a nice and neat society, delineated by the milestones of life. On one particular day, I learned that it meant living the core values of compassion, courage, and love. I've only come to understand fully the extent to which my father exemplified these values as an adult, looking back on the following story. It was a weekday afternoon when I did not have school, 1975. I was 10 years old. My father and I were out and about doing errands. Stopping at church on the way home, my dad learned that a member of the church, we'll say Henry, was being held in the Maryland Penitentiary downtown. We drove to the Maryland Penitentiary. Imagine this building, opened in 1812, comprised of great stone walls blackened by years of Baltimore steel mill dirt, reaching tall, 3 floors high, like some type of medieval castle. Known for its riots of the 60s, noted for overcrowding, killing within the facility, escapes, and horrendous conditions in the 70s. Dad parked the car. Got out of the car, and instantly I heard shouting and cries coming from inside of the building. These were not sounds commonly heard in my neighborhood of post-World War II red brick row houses with manicured lawns and two-story high juniper bushes. We entered the so-called lobby of this building, which is more like a 5x5 room with 3 straight back wooden chairs, solid stone walls, and a counter with a barred window. My father spoke to the officer at the barred window. I remember the officer's shouted answer to my dad. It was harsh, as if my father had done something wrong. My father remained calm and collected when speaking with this outwardly agitated officer. I could hear shouting, banging metal, and pulsing alarms. Sitting in that prison waiting room was chilling. We sat on the hard chairs for 20 minutes until directed to an exit door. Henry was escorted from the building, and my dad had him sit in the back seat of our car. From there, we drove to a nearby hospital where personnel led Henry into what was some type of special care. On the way home, I asked my dad what Henry had done. My father explained that Henry had physically harmed his wife and that this incident was not the first. His wife had finally contacted the police and something was happening to help her. My dad had done what was necessary financially to secure Henry's release from the penitentiary and to provide placement into a suitable social, emotional, and medical care facility. Years later, I learned that Henry had physically abused his wife repeatedly, and that my father had, on numerous occasions, been involved with Henry's situation, including a trial, incarceration, and medical care, as mental health and substance issues were also part of the situation. When my mother learned of our journey that day, she was livid. She raised her voice that day. I will never forget her saying, "Now, Joe, why did you take Laura there? What were you thinking?" His Now, Alice, Laura was fine. We were fine. I couldn't leave her by herself in downtown Baltimore, and I needed to help take care of Henry, so she came with me. She experienced a new part of Baltimore and a key part of my work. My mother moved past this incident, but I think for many years she suspected that any afternoon with my dad might end up in some adventure that might, as we teachers often say, push the envelope. Remember who you are. What did that mean for my father that day? It meant that he was willing and able to help someone who may or may not have warranted much compassion, but did warrant enough respect to be separated from a potentially dangerous prison and placed in appropriate care. It meant that my father was brave enough to include me, a 10-year-old, in his world that often consisted of rather difficult and horrific situations, not just Wednesday night suppers, hymn sings, church services filled with beautiful music, ladies in hats, and good chocolate cookies at the Sunday coffee. It meant trusting that his spouse would move past her own fear when her child was exposed to a world well beyond what was appropriate for her age. Remember who you are. Yes, my father demonstrated that day that one's words and deeds can demonstrate compassion, courage, and love, even in the direst of circumstances. At various points during my life's journey as a friend, teenager, young adult, wife, teacher, and mother, my father continued to say, "Remember who you are." I understood, and I still know. Be true to one's values. Be compassionate, courageous, and loving, despite the situation. My father died several years ago, and even then, during his final days, he reminded me, "Remember who you are." This I believe.